Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved children, I'm so excited to be talking to you today about the fast. Now, how can you fast when you're so young? If you're 4 years old, 3 years old, 5 years old, how are you going to manage the fast? You won't be able to manage it, and Allah knows that. So Allah says it's not compulsory on you until you become an adult. When you're grown up, then you're going to have to fast. In the meantime, all you have to do is just get yourself used to it slowly but surely. So what should you do? Let me give you a few tips, okay? So when your family gets up in the morning for what is known as suhoor, and some people call it the sihri, just before the adhan of fajr, they have a little meal. You get up with them, tell them, please get me up. I want to get up and I want to have my suhoor. Subhanallah. And then you can have that suhoor. Have something light, a little bit of water perhaps, some dates. I usually like to have a banana, maybe a little bit of oats, some yogurt, something healthy, some fruits, but not too much, not a heavy meal. And then when you hear the adhan of fajr, you stop eating. MashaAllah, your fast has begun. And you make an intention, oh Allah, I'm trying my best to fast. I'm still a child. I know it's not compulsory for me, but I want to try. So then, say for example, the adhan went off at 5 o'clock. You stopped eating at 5 o'clock. You try and stretch it thereafter. After Salatul Fajr, you might want to sleep for a while. If you have school, you might want to get up after that for school. But remember, you're fasting. So you're going to go, you're not going to eat or drink. And if you're not feeling well, or if you get dizzy, or if you really feeling very hungry, you're allowed to eat at that point. So take it to the point where you then feel like you have to eat. Some of the children, depending on your age, obviously, they last 5 whole hours. So for 5 hours, from 5 o'clock to 10 o'clock, they haven't eaten a thing. They didn't drink a thing. SubhanAllah, amazing. That is very, very good. And then at 10 o'clock, they have a little snack and they stop to eat again. Up to about 3 o'clock. And then 3 o'clock, they have a little snack again, maybe a little bit bigger. And then they stop eating until the fast opens again at 6 o'clock. Sometimes 7 o'clock. Now, if you're in a country like where I am right now in Africa, the fast is not so long. It's only 13 hours. So it would be easier for you. You might just need one snack in the middle as a child, okay? Because it's not compulsory on you anyway. But we're trying our best and we're going to get there. And then if you're in a country where it's very, very long, 20 hours, 18 hours, it's not going to be so easy. But you can try and do your best. If you fasted from 5 o'clock to 10 o'clock today, tomorrow make it 5 o'clock to 11 o'clock. The next day maybe 5 o'clock to 11:30 or 12 o'clock. And then 5 to 1 o'clock and just have a little lunch and go back. Stop eating again. The idea is to get you used to it. Will you be rewarded for it? Obviously, to try. It's not a proper fast of Ramadan that the adults do, but you're getting there, okay? Maybe in the weekends or when you don't have to go to school, or if the fast is short sometime, you might be able to do the whole fast. If you rest and you take it easy and you don't exert yourself too much for that particular day, you might be able to have a fast or two, subhanAllah. I know of some children as young as 5 and 6 who have fasted every single fast and they managed it. But don't worry, it's not compulsory. I have to make it clear to you that it's not compulsory at this point because you're just a child. So Allah says that it's only for the adults when it's compulsory. For those who are younger, you can start slowly but surely, just like prayer and just like Quran. And I'm going to get to that, inshallah, in one of the episodes, inshallah. So I want you to do myself a favor. Do me a favor. If you are watching this on my official YouTube channel known as Mufti Menk Official, leave a comment at the bottom and I'll try to reply to you. Tell me how you're doing with your fast, how long you can fast in the day, how many times you had to have a snack, whether you've managed a full fast or not, and how old you are, and if you fasted the whole of Ramadan the last time, let me know. You deserve a pat on the back, mashallah. Mashallah, tabarakallah. So my beloved children, remember, we're just going to try our best. And no matter how you've done well. You have done well, because at this stage, like I said, you just have to get the hang of it, get used to it, inshallah. And the idea is once you grow up, you're going to be fasting full time. And then even when it comes to the time of iftar, make sure just before iftar you haven't eaten anything. And then when everyone else is breaking their fast, you sit around and you break your fast with them, you make your dua, you do Salatul Maghrib, and you enjoy that iftar just like everyone else. And inshallah, in that way, you get used to the blessings of this beautiful month of Ramadan. May Allah make it easy for you. And not only am I praying for all our children out there, but I'm sure your parents, your loved ones, those you live with, those around you, would all be cheering you along. But if you're not well, I want to tell you something. It's not a good idea to fast when you know you're not well. You know, you have a fever, you have a flu, maybe you're sick in one way or another. Then don't fast, because the Prophet ﷺ has taught that to the adults as well. It's a leeway from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what about the children? Children, don't worry, it's okay. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for you guys, and I'd like to hear from you. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.